Hello friends, welcome to the chemistry class. Now in today's session I am going to discuss about the osmium tetroxide. This is one of the important reagent for organic synthesis. Now let's start osmium tetroxide. Okay, osmium tetroxide, this reagent used for the dehydroxylation. Okay, seen dehydroxylation. This reagent used for the seen dehydroxylation of the alkene. Osmium tetroxide, they get seen diol. Okay, or it also called the vicinal diol. Vicinal diol. Okay, this is very important reagent. That is osmium tetroxide. Now let's take a general example. For example, I want to make on dehydrogenation of this alkene. Okay, this cyclic alkene. Then the condition is osmium tetroxide, water and acetonazole solvent. Okay, now we get cis diol. Now what is the mechanism of this reaction? Let's see mechanism for dehydroxylation reaction by using osmium tetroxide. Okay, in the first step of mechanism, osmium tetroxide, okay, osmium tetroxide. Now the osmium present in plus state oxidation state. Remember this one. In this case, the osmium present in the plus 8 oxidation state. Now what is the mechanism of this reaction? First, okay, it's like a pericyclic reaction. Okay, this is a pericyclic mechanism. Or the mechanism is like pericyclic reaction. It's a concerted mechanism. In one step, we get first there is the formation of the osmodister. Osmodister. This is called the osmate ester. Or hydrolysis of osmate ester, aqueous hydrolysis, we get corresponding cis diol. Clear? We get corresponding cis diol. Now let's take another example. Okay, this is the transalkane. Transalkane on dehydrogenation by using the osmium tetroxide, water and acetonazole solvent. This is the condition for the dehydrogenation. Okay, now in this case we get cis diol.
if C-sulcin is present. Okay, then again seal the adsorption by using the osmium tetroxide. Acetone as a solvent. Okay, this diol. This to each other. Okay, after rotation by 180 degree, it's look like okay, but osmium tetroxide, it is very expensive. Osmium tetroxide is an expensive reagent, expensive and toxic reagent. Okay, so in the heterosilicon reaction, the osmium tetroxide is convert, that is from plus 8 oxidation state to the corresponding plus 6 oxidation state. Okay, now what is the reaction to convert plus 6 oxidation state to plus 8 oxidation state? The simple reagent or base reagent for this is NaMo. Okay, NaMo, that is a N-methylmorpholine N-oxide. The structure of the NaMo is here is nitrogen O minus. It is a methyl. It is N-methylmorpholine N-oxide. That is a NaMo. Got it? Now let's take another example by using osmium tetroxide in presence of NaMo. NaMo acts as a co-oxidant. Okay, not a co-catalyst. Co-oxidant. That is, it oxidizes osmium present in the 6 oxidation state to the corresponding 8 oxidation state. Okay. Now let's take another example. Osmium tetroxide, N-methylmorpholine N-oxide, water, potassium, potassium reduction as a base. Okay, now we can write like this also. Same. Now in this example, no doubt we get the seen dehydrogenation, but NaMo act as a co-oxidant and it oxidizes osmium 6 to the corresponding osmium 8. Now what is the another reagent or another co-catalyst for the co-oxidation, okay, which act as a co-oxidant? Another co-oxidant is potassium tertiary butyl hydroperoxide, and another one is tertiary amine N-oxide, or we can write like this. Okay, trimethylamine N-oxide is the trimethylamine N-oxide, and another is the tertiary butyl hydroperoxide. Instead of NaMo, We can also use list to Cocket list, but best one is the NaMo, that is N-methylmorpholine N-oxide. Now let's take another example, that is dehydrogenation of the allylic alcohol. Okay, dehydrogenation of the allylic alcohol. Our condition is osmium tetroxide. NaMo, water and acetone. Okay. Now, always remember that the osmium tetroxide gives steam dehydrogenation at less substituted site. Okay. Now, if this OH group present on the oxide, is the above the plane. Okay. This OH group present at the above the plane. Then dehydrogenation at the below the plane. Okay. In presence of osmium tetroxide, NaMo, water and acetone as a condition. Clear? So in this reaction, this OH, we get steam dehydrogenation or cis dehydrogenation at the downside. Okay, but if we want to prepare this compound, that is all the three OH group after dehydrogenation, all the three OH group on the same side, then what is the condition for this? Okay, now the condition for this is osmium tetroxide, then TMEDA, tetramethyl ethylene diamine, okay, DCM, and minus 70 degree centigrade temperature. Okay, this is the condition for the dehydrogenation of the alkene, that is the allylic alcohol. Clear? Now, why we get here the all the three OH group on the upside and here both the OH group on the downside and this OH is the upside. So what is the difference between these two reactions? Now in this case, the tetramethyl ethylene diamine, tetramethyl ethylene diamine act as a ligand and it attack on the first osmium tetroxide. Okay, that is osmium, it bind to the osmium of osmium tetroxide and it increase the electronegativity of this oxygen. Okay, it bind to this osmium and increase the electronegativity of this oxygen. Now this oxygen makes the hydrogen bonding with hydrogen. Okay, got it? This makes the hydrogen bonding with this OH group, that is a hydroxyl group. And because of that, the C-directed dehydrogenation takes place. Got it? So the mechanism is like this. In this case, it is an OH group, okay, alkene. First, osmium tetroxide, that is TMEDA, okay, tetramethyl ethylene diamine. Make a coordination with this osmium and makes this oxygen or this oxo group more electronegative. Okay. And and this oxo group makes hydrogen bonding with this hydroxyl group. So because of that, the dehydroxylation happen on the same side of this OH group. Got it? So we get the product is OH. After dehydrogenation, we get all the three OH group on the same side. Got it? Now let's discuss dehydrogenation of the fumaric acid and malic acid. Dehydrogenation of the fumaric and malic acid. C double bond O OH. This is the structure of fumaric acid. And second one is the malic acid. This is the malic acid. Clear? Now, on dehydrogenation by using the osmium tetroxide, H2 and acetone as a condition, we get steam dehydroxylation. Okay, you know that osmium tetroxide gives steam dehydroxylation, but this product is racemic mixture. It gives the racemic mixture. Okay, that is on dehydroxylation by using the osmium tetroxide, the fumaric acid gives racemic mixture. But in case of the malic acid on dehydroxylation by using the same condition, that is osmium tetroxide and acetone as a solvent, is a dehydroxylation product COH group. After rotation, you can write here like after rotation by 180 degree in a COH group, OH, this OH on the downside. On dehydroxylation by using the osmium tetroxide on malic acid, okay, we get meso compound. This is the difference between dehydroxylation of the fumaric acid and the malic acid. Clear? Now let's take one example from previous unit exam. This is the part of example. This example asked in December 2017 in NET exam. Okay. Condition is osmium tetroxide in methyl mercaptan oxide. Other condition is same. That is water and acetone as a solvent. Now, what is the product? We get steam dehydroxylation. Clear? On the same side. Now, this is all about the osmium tetroxide. This is very important result for the CSR NET SET GATE exam.
So like, share, subscribe to our channel, that is Chemistry RRR. Thank you. Thank you for watching the video.